Welcome to the Azure Cosmos DB Essential Series Season 2. My name is Mustafa. I am a Product Marketing Manager for Cosmos DB. And so far this season, we've walked through how to get started with Cosmos DB. We've talked about how to choose an API, provisioning request units, as well as schema design and partition strategy. Now, in this video, we want to show you how to get your data into Cosmos DB. So, given that you have a target schema, there's some powerful tools like Azure Data Factory that help you ingest that data as well as transform that data. So this is our opportunity to show you two demos where you will see how we can import JSON data and relational data into a Cosmos database with Azure Data Factory, otherwise known as Synapse Pipeline. This is a no-code solution to data migration that can be done right in the portal and is pretty simple to set up once you have an account. So I'm currently in the portal here in ADF, and here you'll see on the left, we have Pipeline 1. So this is our Data Factory canvas. Here we can create different data pipelines. And for the sake of time, I've already created this pipeline with a copy activity. Now, once we configure that copy activity with the origin JSON living on Azure Blob Storage, we can define a source and a sink. In the sink, I want to define that as our Cosmos DB database, which we see defined here. And the source is just the JSON hosted on Blob Storage. Now, if I input the connection string from the container in Cosmos DB, we're pretty much done. And we can just test this connection. See if we run here, we can validate it. And then if we run it, we'll see that the data from our source file has been copied into our Cosmos DB database. So this is awesome and really makes it simple to move JSON data in Cosmos DB. So if you're just getting started and want to poke around with your own JSON documents, you can use ADF and create your own source files, or we'll also share GitHub Lab in the description. Now for the second demo, we'll show denormalization and importing of a relational file with ADF. So in this example, we're copying data from a SQL Server table, denormalizing it into a JSON, and then importing it into Cosmos DB collection. This is going to be nearly the same process as the first demo, but there's an extra step, which is the flattening of the relational table into a JSON document. So if we look at the execute pipeline on the right, we have the same copy data pipeline to the left, and then within this execute pipeline, we have two data flows. A data flow uses the Spark compute engine to transform input data. So there are joins, aggregates, filters, et cetera. And in the first data flow, we have the input, which is a JSON output of the SQL Server table that we did with the copy function. The second is the actual transformation, which takes the source data file and unrolls it. And in this case, you'll see here, I'm unrolling by the topping. If we look in the flattened settings, we see the pairings where we take the columns from our table and rename them to whatever we want them to be called in our flattened JSON document. This is the process of denormalizing. We can give an ID and a type. In this example, it's topping ID and topping type. And the cool part of this is just with a drag and drop method, we can denormalize our table and flatten it into a JSON with no coding at all. So now once we flatten, we write to an out.json, which is just the output of the normalized table. And if we look at data flow 2, all we do is take that out.json and write it to the sink, which is Cosmos DB. And that's it. Thanks for tuning in to the second season of the Azure Cosmos DB Essential Series. We covered some fundamental topics to know on day one, including partition strategy, request units, schema design. And today we showed you how to get data into Cosmos DB with ADF. We hope you learned something and look forward to seeing you next time.